Storm. I'm Stormy, and today I am going to do a really neat video. I already have a what I eat in a day with a whole food plant-based chicken spaghetti, and it is following the starch solution principles, but this is going to be a whole food plant-based chicken spaghetti that is following the starch solution principles of maximum weight loss.
Pause to say that I'm actually making this with pasta, but if you truly want to make this maximum weight loss, you should serve this on rice and cook it just like you would with the regular spaghetti.
So I thought it would be neat to do this video so that you could see the difference in what I'm doing as far as some of the changes that I make whenever I'm following maximum weight loss versus just the regular starch solution. This is exciting for me to remake it maximum weight loss style. So let's go ahead and get started.
So I'm just breaking up half a head of cauliflower. You could use frozen if you like, and I'm just putting it into the steamer pot, and I'm going to put that right on top of some veggies I have cut up to make my cheese sauce and cook this all at one time until they're tender. I'll add the link to my epic cheese sauce above because that's what's going in this recipe. Put it on the stove and, like I said, cook it till they're tender. Then you want to dice up a medium onion, and I'm going to go ahead and scrape that into the frying pan. And then about 3 to 4 cloves of garlic, just dice that up and go ahead and put that right into the frying pan as well. Then I'm going to take 2 portobello mushrooms and cut those up into chunks. Saute the onions and garlic, and then I'm going to add in a little bit of water. I did a water saute here, so no oil. And then once those are cooked down nice and tender, I add in the mushrooms and cook those down until they're tender as well. And whenever they are cooked through, you're going to turn the temperature off and set aside. Also, once the cauliflower is cooked, I'm going to put it into my little blender, and I'm going to add in 1 cup of vegetable broth and then blend it up till it's nice and creamy. And then I'm gonna add that straight to the mushroom and onion mixture. Just mix that in really well, and this is gonna act like the cream of mushroom condensed soup in the recipe, but it's gonna be really light in calories. So the next thing I do is add in the seasonings, and I put in about 1.5 teaspoons of thyme. You can do that to taste. And this next item is an umami blend from Trader Joe's. It's just a dried mushroom blend. You could actually make this yourself, and it's not even required. It's just something I threw in there. And then black pepper to taste. Mix it all up, and then if it's too thick, which I felt like it was, I'm going to end up adding in another cup of vegetable broth. And you can just do this by sight and how thick you actually want your cream of mushroom soup to be. So you may or may not need this extra bit of liquid. Also depends on how watery your cauliflower was to begin with. Just like cream of mushroom soup without all the calories. And I went ahead and put the whole pound of pasta on the boil and cooked it till al dente. And then I'm going to scoop it into a casserole dish and just put it all in there. And the next thing I'm going to end up doing is adding in the cheese sauce. Like I said, the link for this was earlier in the video. And just add in about 1/3 of that. And then I end up adding in 1/2 of the cream of mushroom soup mix. And then a can of green chilies and diced tomatoes. You could use something like Rotel, but I couldn't find any that was low sodium enough for our needs. So I just went ahead and mixed these two together and made it myself. And then you're going to go ahead and mix all of that up and then add in as much cheese sauce as you need for your taste. And you can leave this out or add it. My husband really likes the jackfruit in it, so I put that in there. And this acts as the chicken replacer, and mix that up. But it's just as good without it if you did not want to do that. And I'll add a link to all of the things that I can in the description box so that if you're interested in purchasing any of it, you can find it easily. And then you're just going to put it in a 350 degree oven for about 30 to 45 minutes until it is nice and cooked through. And then just fluff it up and put some on a plate or your bowl. And I love to add in a little bit of extra cheese sauce on top. And then I like to put a little hot sauce on top of that as well, just to give it an extra kick.
Okay, so that's it. And that's how you make this a super easy chicken spaghetti where there's actually no chicken in it. It's jackfruit for the chicken. And the calorie density is super low, but delicious. And look how creamy and yummy. And the awesome thing is that this is a family recipe and you can add extra things on, like if you wanted to make the cheese sauce with cashews so it's a little bit richer for your family members, then you can do that. But I hope that you enjoyed this recipe, and I hope you enjoyed as much as we do if you try it. And as always, thanks so much for watching.